As we predicted in 2017, a Demon's Souls remake has been announced as coming to PlayStation 5 with Bluepoint Games and Sony Japan Studios work. This is incredibly exciting news for any Souls or From Software fan, as it's the game that propelled the studio and series to international fame. A lot of Souls players have enjoyed the games on PC and Xbox and are therefore surprised to see Sony has exclusivity over this title. While there is controversy about the role of exclusives, the fact is that Sony Japan Studio was part of the development of the original game, and Sony Computer Entertainment funded the entire project and owns the IP. It is not unreasonable for Sony to make games for their own platform, and since they are in the business of selling that platform and the games they make for it, we see it unlikely that their titles would make the jump to others in a hurry. This is possible, of course, but it'll likely be long after the game has stopped driving PS5 sales. But what about Atlus and Namco? As we explained back in December 2017, the original game's reviews by Famitsu were not flattering, 2 sevens, a 6, and a 9. Additionally, initial audience tests revealed difficulty was perceived as so high that the marketing team wanted to wash their hands of the project, effectively discarding a global launch. Before the game was released and the game's playing public had a chance to deliver their verdict, Sony had already decided it was way too hard to succeed based on the opinions of marketing executives and the press, and made the significant decision to sell international publishing rights. As a result, the game was published in Japan by Sony, and no amount of Japan hardcore success convinced them that they may be in the wrong. The North American publishing rights were sold to Atlus, and the European rights to Bandai Namco. So did they get the rights back? Following the cult hit properties of Demon's Souls and rolling into the success of Dark Souls, Sony realized that they had made a mistake and set about fixing it. The details of the deal are unknown, but it is clear that this was worked out sometime in 2017 and 18 with the announcement of the simultaneous closure of all Demon's Souls servers worldwide. This was also hinted at by Yasuhiro Kitao, who had a cheeky "Hello, Bulletaria" tweet around that time. Fast forward to 2019, and Miyazaki is asked about a possible remaster and deflects that it would be Sony's decision and that he would not be opposed to another studio taking the project. 2 months after that, the Bluepoint rumors started flying, with the studio stating, "For Shadow of the Colossus, we don't call it a remaster, we coin it a remake due to the complexity of the project. And moving forward to our next project, we call it a re-envisioning given that it goes well beyond what we thought was possible on Shadow of the Colossus." And by December 2019, we, Bluepoint Games, originally remastered Shadow of the Colossus for the PS3 and then remade it for the PS4. It's the only one we've touched twice and to date is our greatest achievement, so it's easy to say that it is our personal favorite. However, there's no question in our minds that our current project will become the achievement we're most proud of. This leads us to last week, where the internet was taken by storm by rumors of a Bloodborne or Demon's Souls remaster, and here we are. The dots connect, and there's a clear picture of ownership and decisions that lead to the game becoming a PS5 title. Remaster and remake are mainly referencing the engine, core aspects, and groundwork of a game. A remaster would imply a game's graphics have been retouched, frame rate improved, and maybe animations balanced, but the base character models and such would remain as they are, and you should not expect significant differences with the original. A remake is more of all bets are off, and a re-envisioning, which is what Blueprint has called this, implies even more. So what should we expect in the Demon's Souls remake? If the game has been rebuilt from the ground up, as the Sony video description says, we expect to see 4K graphics at 60fps. I expect that the animations and models have been reworked to match this, and this would likely impact the game's combat. For those of you who are unfamiliar or don't remember the original title, it was a lot less fluid than what you've grown accustomed to with Dark Souls, and it had several exploitable balance issues and enemy AI. The game also ran on dedicated servers rather than P2P, which allowed for the whole world to align to the entire player base performance. This is a feature I'm very much hoping has been left in place, as the P2P aspects of Dark Souls and their netcode have left much to desire, given you feast or famine moments of co-op and PvP, and pretty much inventing the dreadful lag stat. I did a frame by frame of the trailer to try and discern as much as possible regarding the content, so let's have a look. The intro scene is clearly redone, but remains true to the original work, with a crescendo of now nostalgic tunes letting you know what's up. We then go to the Tower of Latria sequence soon after this boss, where you are elevated to new heights, much like your trip to an Orlando in Dark Souls. We then catch a glimpse of the boss that will make you use that sword from Dark Souls 3, and of course the incredibly deadly skeletons of the Shrine of Storms, and those Reaper bastards that killed me way more times than I'm going to admit on this video. The impressive Tower Knight boss also makes an appearance, and we can see his arena remains largely unchanged. The last two enemies introduced are none other than Flame Lurker and the fearsome Dragon God, but here's the twist. I must have played this game for thousands of hours, and has become the obsession that essentially started Fex for Life. yet I cannot remember a scene like the one depicted for Dragon God. Could we be getting a new setup for this boss fight? Or is this simply an intro scene to the attack on Boletaria? We'll have to wait to find out, but I'm pretty excited. How about the broken Archstone? I'm going to go into full speculation mode, but we heard something about a fractured mode being leaked by PlayStation themselves due to a bad video description that was later on amended. It is very likely that mode means something graphics related, but to me, it brought me straight to the mysterious broken Archstone we could never visit and always wanted DLC or a sequel for. Could this be the time? Will we finally learn what lies within the Land of the Giants and what led to its breaking? You can have a little look at the cut content that Dataminer SanaDisk found for a teaser of what could come. No release date has been announced yet, but everything here seems to signal a PS5 launch window. Souls titles move consoles, and PlayStation will want to have a good arsenal of content to push people to jump from PS4 to PS5. So we're going to bet our souls against holiday 2020, together with PS5 launch, pending any delays to it from unexpected events. So what do you think of the announcement? Are you hyped? Do you have theories on what changes might be? Do you have favorites that you hope stay the same or things you hate that must be reworked? Let us know in the comments and refresh your game knowledge by visiting our Demon Souls wiki.